Let's play a little game, a little sentence game. Okay. I will say one sentence, and you just say what you think about it immediately. One, two, three sentences about that. All right. And let us know why you think about it, that about it. First sentence and quote is, it's not possible to build wells today anymore.
I would say false, false, false. I think it is possible for anyone. Now, everyone's going to be starting at a different place, obviously, financially, but it is possible for everyone. And I think it's a really disservice to believe that it's not possible. So you may have to change your habits. You may have to change the way you're looking at money, but anyone today can choose to do something different with their money and build wealth.
Yeah. Credit cards enable financial flexibility and provide points.
False, false, false. I guess they do provide points. I'll say that. Yeah. I am a weird one where I am against the credit card. I am. Yeah. I think when you spend with a credit card, statistically, you spend 8 to 12% more. So there's something to be said about that. But it also gives this avenue of being able to get what you want when you want it, even if you don't have the money. And yeah. I just watch so many people, especially in America, just rack up this lifestyle that they can't afford. And it's dangerous. So I think using a debit card is key. And then I'll say this to the points aspect. Banks and credit card companies are not these generous entities. They're not.
I heard about it.
Yes, they are not just giving away money just out of the goodness of their hearts. No, they are making a lot of money of people who are not paying their credit cards off and are paying interest and fees month after month after month after month. Millions of people. So in order to get those free points and airline miles, you're getting those because other people are mismanaging their money. So it's this whole toxic way of living with money that I'm like, I don't want any part of it. So I have a debit card and I say no to credit cards.
Me too, by the way. That's my grandmother told me never to buy anything on credit. I never bought anything except real estate on with mortgages. So, yes. But I really, what I also find so toxic about credit cards, because they come at the end of the month, you lose control. You lose control, you lose budget. And I love control and simplicity. And when people come with airline miles and say, I have this free flight, I say the time you could have invested instead of focusing on your points in changing your money habits and making more money, you could have bought 10 times the flights. So,
Robin, we are best friends. Did we know this?
Yeah. All right. Okay. Next one. I have three more. I use 0% financing and use the interest spread for investing.
I would say mathematically, that makes sense. But we're not always talking about math when we're talking about money. Money has a completely different emotional toll on us than we give it credit for. And so the idea of living without payments, without owing anyone anything, debt-free living will give you more sleep at night. It'll give you more options. And it'll actually make you think through a lot of what's going on in your finances currently versus depending on payments. Even if the math seems like it's smart, life can still happen. I'll say 2009 for us in America, right? And who knows? If you lose a job, what's going to happen? So,
and most people having 0% financing simply don't do investing at all. So that's another problem, statistically proven. Okay, two more. The next one is my most fun one. And then I'll tell you a funny story why the TikTok community will freak out. I lease my car because it's cheaper than buying one with cash.
According to Money Magazine, leasing a car is the most expensive way to finance a vehicle. So when it comes to cars, when you are going into debt or even leasing something, you are putting money and paying interest on something that's going down in value. So I want you to do the opposite. I want you to actually let your money make money. You know, real estate's a great example. I am not against a mortgage. I think a mortgage is the one type of debt I'm okay with. And part of that is it's a huge purchase, right? And over the history of specifically in America, real estate goes up. It goes up. But when you drive a car off a car lot, the amount of money that is just gone instantly. And then again, you're paying more money for this car than when you sell it in 5 or 7 years or the lease is up, it's depreciated. It doesn't, mathematically, it drives me crazy. A car loan and car leasing, mathematically, it's the hardest for me to wrap my mind around. So save up and pay cash for your car.
Yeah, and people buy cars they actually cannot afford. And I'm driving a $3,000 beat up a BMW for 10 years, and I'm always laugh a lot about that because you never can see what else people have. But on TikTok, we have a lot of videos against the leasing because it's like it tries to seduce young people in driving a car they cannot afford. And when you start your career as an adult with $50,000 in debt, it's a disaster. And for an asset that depreciates in value. Okay, last question. Last question might apply to one person here in the room. Not you. I don't budget. I go with the flow.
I would say you're probably wasting a lot of money. A budget, if you do a budget, like the first 3 months, it's going to be hard. But once you get on track and you do it, it's going to feel like you got a raise. And again, a budget doesn't mean you can't have fun. A budget doesn't mean that you can't, you know, go out to eat and enjoy a great dinner out with friends. I mean, yeah, you can do all those things still. But a budget just gives you control and a plan. And again, it gives you permission to spend.
Okay, Rachel, thank you very much for reminding me for that again. I hope Katja does not see this. And last question to you is, you now shared a lot for our community and a lot of concrete examples, a lot of insights. Is there anything our community, insurance and finance professionals around the world, can do for you?
Oh, can do for me? Oh, my goodness. I mean, I don't know. I'm here for you guys. So if you want to listen to the podcast or watch the Rachel Cruze show, you can do all of that if you want. If you want to learn more, you can go to RamseySolutions.com or RachelCruze.com. But yeah, I mean, I feel like I am here to help deliver content when it comes to money, just like you, Robin. And so I think it's a fun job that we get to do is to help people in this way.
Rachel, thank you very much for being on our show.
Thank you so much for having me.